Have you ever had the opportunity to do something way out of your comfort zone and you didn't feel like you could do it? Someone presented you with an incredible work opportunity or challenge and you doubted yourself. You just didn't have the confidence to make it happen. Well, that's extraordinarily common. So many of us doubt ourselves and have low self-esteem, and that's just not necessary in today's world. And women in particular are subject to this. I myself dealt with this as I grew up in an alcoholic family and in my early 20s really held myself back. And I discovered that there are lots of things you can do to improve your self-esteem and build your confidence and be a more successful woman. We have 75 to 80,000 thoughts a day. And sadly, for most of us, 70% of our thoughts are negative. We're judging ourselves. We think we should have said something better, done something better. We're criticizing ourselves. We're doubting ourselves. It's that constant mind chatter, and you don't need that. There are ways that you can actually change that. So often, people are doubting themselves because they're trying to please everybody around them and coming up short. People pleasers have a tendency to say yes to way too much and do too many things for others and commit to much more than they can actually accomplish. And then inevitably they fail and they drop the ball and they lose their credibility with the other person. Broken agreements destroy relationships and it destroys trust. So what's the solution? The solution is to not say yes immediately. When someone asks you to do something and you're not sure if you can do it, say, "Let me get back to you tomorrow," and take the 24 hours to really think about it, look at your schedule, and then decide whether you want to commit to that agreement. And then once you do, write it down. Or if you can't do it, say that as well. We're usually pretty good at keeping our agreements with others, but often not as clear about our agreements with ourselves. And that can create self-sabotage. It goes something like this. You go to bed thinking, "Oh, I'll get up tomorrow morning at 5:30 and go to the gym." And then 5:30 comes and you roll over and you hit the snooze alarm and you don't get up. And if you create a pattern of that, you start to destroy your self-trust. It undermines your confidence and you've broken agreements with yourself. And that really has an impact on your ability to believe in yourself. Again, the solution is to write down those agreements. Don't commit to them unless you know that you can do them, and then set up a system of discipline where you actually do keep your agreements. People who keep their agreements have high integrity and believe in themselves, and I want that for you. Another way that you can build your confidence is to sit with someone who believes in you completely. Might be your partner, a loved one, or a dear friend. And do this exercise. It's called the 3 minutes of praise. You sit with them, and you're going to do the same thing for them, so that's why they'll do it for you. You sit with them, and they give you nothing but praise for 3 minutes. They talk about all the different areas of your life, and you can probably record this, so that would be useful for you to listen to it later. All the areas of your life, and they talk about what they admire about you and how they see you succeeding and what is special and unique about you. You will usually find that this is an astonishing and deeply moving experience because many of the things that we take for granted about ourselves, our innate strengths and abilities, we have a tendency to forget about or dismiss, and yet that's what others admire most about us. You do the same thing for the other person, and you may even choose to do this exercise with two or three people. It is amazing what it will do for you. Another tool to build your confidence is to take a look at the successes that you've had throughout your life. I always recommend to my coaching clients to take out a pad and write down all the significant milestones and successes and things they've achieved since they've been born. Learning how to walk. Graduating high school, going to college, getting that first job, perhaps buying your first home. Whatever it is that you've achieved that you feel good about, write that down. That is now your reference points of success log. And whenever you're challenged and you have a new opportunity that you're not sure you can handle, you turn to that success log and you reference it and you go, okay, I did this, this, and this. I can handle this new challenge. It's important to give yourself credit for all that you do. You've heard me say that I recommend to my coaching clients to record 10 successes a day, and that doesn't have to be a huge success. Anything that you intended to do and actually fulfilled in your brain is considered a success. So you want to record 10 of those every night, followed by 3 new things that you're grateful for. I did this when I was trying to develop my self-esteem many years ago, and it made a huge difference in my well-being. At the end of the year, I could look back, and I probably did 285 days out of the 365, and I went, wow, look at all that I accomplished. I'm effective. I'm successful. I still do this today because I'm writing a book, running 2 businesses, traveling and speaking, and sometimes I forget what I've done. I want you to be as confident as possible and achieve your dreams and keep your fire burning.